Hello, I'm Professor Sabel from SAVIR Center in Magdeburg. Today I speak to you in this video about a new therapy that we have developed for patients that suffer vision loss because of diseases of the eye or the brain, where the nervous system is involved. And these two regions are affected by diseases such as glaucoma, diabetic retinopathy, optic nerve damage of various causes, and so on. So the idea is that in such diseases, they are not only blind areas and normally seeing areas of the visual field, but rather they are fairly large number of areas of partial vision, which we call residual vision. And it's these areas of residual vision that have the greatest potential for improvement. The way we accomplish this activation of these cells is by providing electrical impulses to the brain and to the eye with alternating current. These are very tiny current pulses that you can hardly feel, which are delivered with electrodes to the eye, which then transmits the current not only to the retina, but also along the optic nerve to the brain itself. So the main mechanism of this therapy is that electric current is able to dilate blood vessels. So the silent cells who have been inactive because they were lacking blood supply now get more oxygen again and they get more glucose so that they can recover their activity, which is the basis of the recovery of the vision. In addition, because of the stimulation, the brain somehow learns to better utilize the signals it gets from the retina so that it can be better able to process the visual signals and allow you to see things again, better being able to read or less foggy vision. Now the therapy is given for about 10 days, and if you ask the question, does it have any side effects? The answer is very little. No serious side effects were reported ever with the therapy, neither by us nor by other colleagues. Patients may have a little bit of a headache that subsides within a short period of time, or they feel tired. But besides these very rare and mild cases of side effects, there are no risks of this therapy. So the first measure we have studied and also have published in the scientific literature is the size of the visual field. The visual field is that area which you can see when you look straight ahead. In our hands, with following the therapy, we noticed that the visual field improves on average by about 25%. That means the size of the visual field gets larger. If you measure it in another way, by just looking at the section of the visual field that has an impairment that is missing, and then you measure its size, the effects are so strong that the average improvement is in the order of 60% of the regained visual field sector. What's most important for you as a patient is, what does it mean for me subjectively? How can I notice these improvements in everyday life? Well, let me give you some examples, because also this varies between a lot of patients depending on what your deficit exactly is. So most patients experience a visual field enlargement which may be smaller or bigger. Other patients improve their foggy vision, that is, the fog that you feel is clearly reducing so that you improve your acuity. You can more easily see, for example, objects or faces, or is easier to read because you can identify the letters better, which is, by the way, independent of the glasses you are wearing. So it is not an issue of the optics of the eye. Other patients report they feel safer walking on uneven ground or in unfamiliar environments, or they feel that generally their glare has reduced and that things, especially far vision, has improved when you look at things at the distance. Now, the number of patients who report some sort of subjective improvement in one way or the other is about 80%. That means out of 100 patients, 80 patients notice subjective improvements, whereas 20% approximately have no such improvements, or they are so small that they don't notice. So in sum, given the facts that current thinking is that vision loss is irreparable, irreversible, do not get discouraged by such statements, because there is more light at the end of the tunnel. It is possible to improve vision in diseases such as glaucoma, optic nerve damage, or even damage to the brain after stroke or after brain trauma. In summary, our therapy is unique in that we are not dwelling on what you can't do, but we improve the residual vision that you still have. And if you have more questions, please look at other videos that I prepared, or give us a call or reach us on the website. Thank you for your attention, and goodbye, Professor Sabel in Magdeburg, Germany.